Hello, and welcome to the Trempealeau United Methodist Church. I'm Pastor Mary Beth. This is June 6th, 2021. And we're continuing our summer series called A Rainbow Summer, Celebrating God's Promises. Today, we celebrate the color white, you can see from the altar. So in this scripture story that we're going to be talking about today, it's from Exodus, and the Israelites have been wandering in the wilderness for 2 months now, give or take, after being freed from slavery in Egypt. They brought food with them, but it's all gone now. They're hungry and wonder if maybe they shouldn't have stayed slaves in Egypt, where at least they got some food. They bitterly complain to Moses about this, and God hears their complaints and sends them quail to eat at night and a mysterious white substance called manna to eat during the day. And this is where we come in Exodus, in chapter 16, beginning with the 13th verse. In the evening, quails came up and covered the camp, and in the morning there was a layer of dew around the camp. When the layer of dew lifted, there on the surface of the wilderness was a fine flaky substance, as fine as frost on the ground. When the Israelites saw it, they said to one another, "What is it?" For they did not know what it was. Moses said to them, "It is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat. This is what the Lord has commanded. Gather as much of it as each of you needs, an omer to a person, providing to the number of persons, all providing for those in their tents." The Israelites did so, some gathering more, some less. But when they measured it with an omer, those who gathered much had nothing over, and those who gathered little had no shortage. They gathered as much as each of them needed. And then we go to verse number 33. And Moses said to Aaron, "Take a jar and put an omer of manna in it, and place it before the Lord to be kept throughout your generations." May these words bless you this week. Now, many years ago, I was at a bridal shower and watching the bride-to-be open her gifts. As she tore the paper away from one gift, a strange white container emerged. There was a colander type of bowl sitting inside of a clear bowl, and then the lid on top had a red handle on it. And she gushed, "Oh, thank you," turning it over in her hands, and we all kind of met each other's eyes and asked in our minds, "What is it?" Well, when those Israelites woke up after having their first meal of barbecued quail the night before and rubbed the sleep from their eyes, they saw a whole different landscape spread out before them. All around them, a powdery white substance like a dew covered the ground. They blinked in the morning light and they looked at each other and they said, "What is it?" Now, Moses explained to them that God had heard their complaints and provided a new kind of bread for them to eat. They were to take only what they needed for their family for one day, except on Saturdays when they were supposed to collect enough for 2 days, because that way they wouldn't have to work on Sunday, which was the day that they set aside for the Lord, the Sabbath day. Now, of course, some of them were greedy, or maybe especially hungry on that first morning, so they scooped up a whole bunch of it and took it back to their tent. And it was more than they needed, this new God bread that they were given. Well, they learned their lesson, because by the next morning, the extra was really stinky and it was full of worms. By day two, everybody followed the rules. The word manna in Hebrew means, "What is it?" There was a lot the Israelites didn't know. Think of it, they'd led pretty sheltered lives as slaves. But what did they know? Here are three things that they knew that we can take with us. Number one, God provided for the Israelites the manna for one day. Just enough, not too much. In 2021 in America, and maybe in much of the world, maybe we've lost touch with what is just enough, not too much. What is it? It's a brand new day every day. What is God providing for you that is just enough, even though you feel like complaining to God that it's not enough? Number two, God told them that they had to gather the white manna. He didn't just put it on their plates. What is it? It's a job to do. Just as we trust that God provides what we need, we understand that we play a part in this provision of God. When the Israelites rose in the morning, they had purpose. Not only did they have to go out and collect the manna, they had to remember God's directions and obey them. Am I aware of and aligned with what God intends for my life? And number three, God directed them to teach the next generations about manna. What is it? A lesson to be passed on. From the very beginning of our Bible, God instructs us to tell the stories of faith. We are to share the wisdom that we learn and how it informs our life. In the Gospel of Matthew, when Jesus has resurrected from the grave, he gives the disciples a new commandment, and it is the cornerstone for United Methodism and really for Christianity. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded to you. And then here comes God's big promise. And remember, I am with you to the end of the age. Are we sharing the love of Christ in the ways that we live and speak and work and play? This morning, in church, we're going to be eating this manna. We're going to be having this communion, this portion of love and care provided by God. And as we speak these communion words and we place this wafer or this white bread on our tongues, we might wonder, what is it really other than flour and water? It is the love of God given for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Love. It takes so many forms that we wonder from time to time, what is it really? Except children, they seem to have it figured out. A little boy named Billy, who's four, has this to say about it. When someone loves you, the way they say your name is different. You just know that your name is safe in their mouth. Bonnie, who is seven, says, love is what's in the room with you at Christmas if you stop opening presents and listen. And Tiffany, who is also four, has a story. She lives near an elderly fellow who recently lost his wife. And one day when she was out playing in the yard, she saw him sitting on his front step and he had tears on his face. And she went over and she crawled up on his lap and she just sat there. And when her mother asked her, what did you say to our neighbor? She said, nothing. I just helped him cry. What is it? The Israelites asked. Even at that bridal shower, when we all asked it, the answer to the question was love. It came in the form of a salad spinner, because that's what the contraption was, but it was given with love. Oh, and they've been married now for 30 years. This summer, we're celebrating the promises of God. As we celebrate these promises of God, we can be assured that each one of them is grounded in the love and loyalty of God. It's hard for us to comprehend the complete love, the complete depth of God's faithfulness, but we can open our hearts and we can receive the promises provided. Amen. And now will you say the Lord's Prayer with me? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now go into your week, knowing that God's promises are for you, knowing that Jesus Christ helps you receive them and the Holy Spirit meets you in the stillness of your heart. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. God bless.